development of industrial strain. The industrial strain appears to be the one of the important factor that we have with the particularly in the biochemical industries, and this industrial strain should have different characteristics, and first characteristics this should be the genetically stable, and genetically stable means the biochemical characteristics of the organism should be same, because you know that organism, microorganism has several generation. They have changed the generation, the characteristics of the organism should not be changed. The genetically stable organism is very important. Now, if you compare this with the wild strain, this is most unstable, genetically unstable. So, suppose we work with the wild strain and get some good product formation, but next time we can have the repeatability of this reaction. Now, most of the industry, they cannot compromise with the productivity. Productivity of the industry should remain same, because at the end of the day, the top management will see that how much product is produced in the industry. If the product formation is less, naturally that is not desirable for any industry. So they are come up with lot of question to the operation people. So genetical stability of the organism is very important, and it should have rapid growth, because cells should have rapid growth characteristics. And high production rate, because here I want to tell you that the product concentration plays very important role in any kind of chemical and biochemical industries. Now, if the product concentration is less, then our recovery cost, because I told you that whenever we market any kind of product, it should be in a purified form. If the concentration is very less, your purification cost will be very high, which is undesirable. So this industrial strain has a high productivity, that high rate production, high concentration of product that formation take place. The another very important factor is to utilize the wide variety of the inexpensive substances, because that organism should have the capability of wide type of different type of substrate. If they use one type of substrate, for the timing it might be cheaper, but as the time passes on, and then since that source, the people start the source from where he is collecting the raw material, they are finding that this has lot of demand, they keep on rising, increasing the price of that particular material. So if you have multiple choice of the raw materials, naturally that you can control the cost of your production to a great extent. The short time of the fermentation, because in the industry every time is very costly, because they count money for that. So the time of fermentation plays very important role in the fermentation industry. That should be as low as possible, because by using the industrial strain, that time of fermentation can be reduced. The fewer then byproduct formation, that is also very important aspect, that byproduct formation should be as low as possible. More byproduct formation, that means your substrate will go for some not to produce your desired product, but other than the desired product, which is not acceptable. So industrial strain give you fewer byproducts, that is most desirable thing. Ability to undergo genetic manipulation, because why it is required, because to get desired change in the organism, so that we can increase our productivity, we can increase our product concentration, we can get our desired product. And ready harvesting, that is also very important, because cell, particularly we have, I told you that different type of cells we have bacteria, we have algae, we have fungi. So in case of bigger cells like fungi, you don't have any separation problem, but when you go for bacteria, the bacteria is a very tiny particles. The bacterial size varies from 0.5 to 2 microns. So separation problem is there. So harvesting is a very important aspect of that. So how quickly you separate that organism, that is also very important, that plays very important role. So what we are covering in this course, that not only on the development of this, how the industrial strength and how to preserve this strength, that also we are going to discuss. Now let us discuss about what is the difference between the wild strength and the industrial strength. As you know, wild strength basically in the environment, because if you look at the soil, we have different type of bacteria that is available, different type of organism, whatever organisms we have, all organisms, most of the organism is available in the soil. So that is that if we bring that and isolate in the lab, and this organism we consider as a wild strain. So wild strain is the reproducibility, that is the growth rate and product formation rate and titer is very poor as compared to the industrial strain. Industrial strain has the high productivity in product formation rate and titer, and I told you that concentration of the product has great influence on the cost of production, because recovery cost will be reduced to a great extent if the concentration product is very high. Then another important drawbacks is that wild strain, they are susceptible to the product inhibition. Because as the product concentration increases, it inhibits the growth of the organism. So in case of industrial strain, high tolerance of the product inhibition. I can give the example of the yeast cells, that approximately 1 gram of glucose produces 0.51 gram of ethanol. Now if I want to increase the alcohol concentration with in the fermentation, but now if you look at in the early days, that most of the fermentation industry, they produce the ethanol about 7 to 8%. And nowadays the industry, they are producing about 14 to 15%. Now for producing the 14 to 15%, the glucose concentration should be as high as 30%, which is very high. And as we increase the glucose concentration, then osmotic pressure on the fermentation broth will be high. So you know, that causes the shrinkage of the organism. So organism cannot grow properly. So that means the organism should have the osmotolerance. So industrial strength, they have that capability. They can withstand that high osmotic shock. This is another advantage we have. Then poor genetical stability, I told you before also, this is the wild strain, they have poor genetical stability, whereas the industrial strain, they have high genetical stability. Ability to use the various substrate, here also we ability to use the various substrate, but we use the cheaper substrate, and a wide variety of substrate can be used by the industrial strain. And in case of wild strain, we have the poor substrate conversion rate, and here very high substrate conversion rate. These are the different advantages we have when you use the industrial strain. So that is why the industrial strain is preferred by the industry, and naturally the cost of the industrial strain is very high, because this is specially prepared by the different lab for the industrial purpose. Now if you look at how the industrial strain development is taking place, that we have three things we can see: that strain development, that is in upstream processing, then midstream process and downstream process, that is like this. The in the strain development, first we select the microbial host, that where we want to have the changes, that you know, then construction of the biosynthetic pathway for the non-native bioproducts, improvement of self tolerance against the bioproducts, removal of the negative regulation, flux rerouting for cofactor and precursor, the optimization of metabolic fluxes through the relevant biosynthetic pathway, use of high throughput tools for system level metabolic analysis. So you know that these are things that we want to work with for the strain development, because I shall discuss that how we develop this, but this is the main purpose of doing this, where we wanted to we guide the organism in such a way we can get the higher amount of product formation. Then if you come to the fermentation process, use of effective and cheap and easily obtainable carbon source and chemically defined media, because this this should influence that one. Then optimization of culture condition and feeding strategy, performance of batch and fed batch culture, evolution of product performance and scale up of bioreactors. That's very important. And in the separation, use of effective and cheap and easily obtainable carbon source and chemically defined minimal media, and minimization of byproducts, I told you before, and optimization of culture condition, that is at a different pH we want to carry out. So these are all interactive things that we have, that is how it influences in the fermentation process. Now, industrial, that strain that is developed in five main steps involved. One is the isolation of the industrial organism, which organism we are looking for, which organism we ask. For example, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, that is used for alcohol production. Now, suppose the Saccharomyces cerevisiae is mainly used the hexose sugar. Now, we want to use also the pentose sugar, because we want to use some kind of pentose sugar for the formation of ethanol. Naturally, that we shall have to improve upon this organism. We shall have to do the genetic modification of the organism to have the capability of the organism, so that we can convert the pentose into the ethanol. The screening of new products, that is very important. Then identification of metabolites, that is also important. Maintenance of microbial isolates and strain improvement. These are the several things that is involved with the industrial strain development. Now, another that other five distinct approaches for obtaining the new microbial metabolites from the microbes. That is screening. We do the screening we do the microbial screening and try to find out which microbes is good for the product formation. Then chemical modification of a known microbes, microbial substances, biotransformation, that also we can easily carry out with the help of microbes, and interspecific protoplast fusion, because we know that different organism has different characteristics. So if you do the protoplast fusion, it is possible that characteristics that another organism can switch over to the other organism, and you get the properties of that organism in the system. And genetic cloning, I told you that insulin, it kind of, this is used for the diabetes patient, and insulin is a kind of protein that is available in the human system. So we can produce microbially, how we can produce, we isolate the gene which is produced that insulin, and we that gene we overexpress in our host, the E. coli, so that we can, through the fermentation process, we can produce the insulin, and we can use for our day-to-day life. Then question comes, how to do the preservation of the industrial strain. Industrial culture must be preserved and maintained in such a way to eliminate the genetic changes, protect against the contamination, and retain viability. This is very important. All these three factors is to be considered. Because one is the we should keep in a manner so that genetic change should not be there. So you should not keep exposure to the UV rays and other chemicals, other adverse conditions, so that some kind of changes can take place. And then protect against the contamination, because our air atmosphere contains a lot of microorganisms. Because particularly contamination problem is very problematic in the industry. I work with citric acid industry. We use the cane molasses for the production of citric acid, and we observe that our main problem with this fermentation process is the contamination by the yeast cells, because cane molasses can be easily used by yeast cell for the production of ethanol. So, and if you look at the doubling time of yeast is much less as compared to fungi, so it can grow very rapidly as compared to fungi. So that is why that in this our citric acid industry, we are very much scared of these yeast cells, and we try to remove this organism so that we don't have any problem with the citric acid productivity. And retain of viability, because viability, as you know, that the organism should be viable. so that we can it can grow properly and give the desired product. And mostly that industrial fermentation process, the when you do the inoculation of the organism, the log it should be either mid log phase to late log phase, so that the organism should grow in a proper manner. Now, about the preservation of the industrial strain is concerned, the methods to keep the organism metabolically active, the beautifully transferred to the fresh media, this is one important aspect that we have. Overlaying the culture with the mineral oil, that is another thing that we have. Storage of sterile soil, then saline suspension. These are the different methods through which we can keep this organism metabolically active. The methods where organisms are submerged in metabolic state, like drying in vacuum, then lyophilization. Lyophilization is considered as a freeze drying. Freeze drying means that organism that will be frozen, then they do the water molecule that present in the solid state that will go to the vapor phase. So the organism can be preserved for a longer period of time, about 30 years we can preserve that organism in the viable conditions. Then use of liquid nitrogen, that is another way that we can do that. Then storage of silica gel, storage in silica gel, that is another way we can preserve these microorganisms. Now, the preservation of the industrial strain and comparison with the different methods is given here. One is periodical transfer. The variable periodical transfer to new media includes the frequency, media use, and holding temperature. This can lead to increase the mutation rate and production of variant. Then mineral oils land, this is another important aspect that we have. A stock culture is grown on a slant and covered with sterilized mineral oil, and slant can be stored at refrigerated temperature. Then minimal media and distilled water or water agar, that is the use, the wash culture was stored under refrigeration, and this culture can be viable only for 3 to 5 months or longer, not for very long period of time. The freezing of the growth media is not reliable because can result in damage of microbial structure with some microbes, and however this can be useful mean of the culture maintenance. Drying, this is another important thing, that is the culture are dried on sterilized oil, soil, and on sterilized filter paper disc in gelatin drops, and this can be stored in a desiccator at refrigerated temperature or frozen to improve the viability. The technique that I was telling you, that which is used by the industry, that is the freeze drying technique. Freeze drying technique, water is removed by sublimation process in presence of cryoprotective agent and sealing it in an ampoule, and can lead to the long term viability with 30 years having been reported, because 30 years we can preserve this organism in the viable condition. Then ultra freezing, this is another aspect that we have. Liquid nitrogen at minus 196 degree centigrade is used. Culture or fastidious microorganism have been preserved for more than 15 years. So these are the different way we can preserve the microorganism. Now let me discuss about the method of industrial strain development. The strain improvement optimization of microbial activity we can do by optimizing the environmental parameters like the temperature, pH, substrate concentration. I told you that osmotolerant culture, that can we increase the microbial activity. Then nutrition, this is very important. I can recently we work on that, and we find that particularly that in case of when we use some kind of waste material for the production of some useful product, waste material usually doesn't contain much of nutrient, has less nutrients. So if the micronutrients if we add to the waste material, then your microorganism can grow properly and give the desired product. that is there. One of the most fundamental approaches of the strain development is done with the help of recombinant DNA techniques, because I told you the example is the insulin production, and that the other examples are site direct mutagenesis, protoplast fusion and metabolic engineering. Metabolic engineering plays very important role, because you can nurture the metabolic pathways to get the desired amount of product, because this is very important. Most of the strain improvement procedure aim to increase the yield of the product. This is the main purpose that. So mutation is a very known technique that is used in the industry for the improvement of the productivity of the strain. Mutation is a process which can induce the changes either in the genotype or phenotype characteristics of the organism. So two type of changes that occur in the organism, one is genetically and another is phenotype change, that can be done with the help of mutation. And mutation may be of two type, one is called spontaneous mutation and another is induced mutation. The spontaneous mutation, which is occur in vivo, in vivo means there itself, organism itself, the mutation that occurs naturally without the need of any mutagens. The induced mutation, the mutation that occurs when the organisms are exposed to certain chemicals or physical agents. So now we have different type of mutagens. We have physical mutagens, we have chemical mutagens. Physical mutagens, we have non-ionizing that radiation, ionization radiation. Then chemical mutagens, we have alkylating agent, base analogs and intercalating agent. So the different type of mutagens we use in the industry for the development of the strain. Let me take the example of the non-ionizing the radiation. Examples is the ultraviolet radiation, and they have long penetration power. You know that ultraviolet radiation has a very shorter wavelength, and major effect of ultraviolet radiation is the formation of pyrimidine dimer, because you can see that here two nitrogen base is there. This is thiamines, and there how the dimer formation is there, that you can see that here dimer formation take place. But cytosine and cytosine thiamine dimers are less prevalent. Now ionization radiation, this is actually applied where that non-ionization radiation is not effective. They include the gamma, the beta rays, gamma rays, alpha rays, which causes the ionization in the media. They are used for mutagenesis only if other mutagens cannot be used, when the cells are impermeable to the UV rays. They have more penetrating power as compared to UV rays. Cells, when exposed to this radiation, results in the formation of free radicals, which further cause the genetic mutation. So this is the little bit effective, more effective as compared to non-ionizing radiation. Now we have chemical mutagens that we use. Mainly these chemical mutagens we use to change the nitrogen bases, that you know, alkylation of nitrogen bases by alkylating agent either removed or the base is more or base or modify it. You can see this is the thiamine, adenine, cytosine and guanine, that here how by using EMS means the ethyl methane sulfonate, methyl methane sulfonate, there are two alkylating agents that can be used for mutation purpose. This is how is used to change the characteristics of this nitrogen base, that is called, that is a part of the gene. Then methods of industrial strain improvement, that is also very important. The one is the genetic recombination. The recombination may be defined as the formation of new gene combination, combination among those present in the different strain. As I told you, suppose one organism doesn't have a particular gene, we want that particular gene in that particular organism. So we try to take the gene from other organism, and we clone in a kind of plasmid and then overexpress in the organism to get the desired property in that particular organism. That is called recombination techniques, and it is highly successful in plants and animals. Recombination is used for both genetic analysis as well as strain improvement. and it is used to bring the desirable the present two or more strain into single strain to increase the product yield and to generate the new products. The recombination may be based on the following: sexual reproduction, parasexual cycle, and protoplast fusion. The different ways that we can do the recombination. Now, finally, I want to tell you that recombinant. What is the recombinant DNA technology? You might be knowing that. Still, let me tell you, the recombinant DNA technology involves the isolation and cloning of the gene of interest. Because gene of interest means of what particular gene? You know that the gene is coding a particular protein, and the production of necessary gene construct using the appropriate enzymes, and then transfer and express this into the appropriate host organism. So this is the technique. This is the kind of innovative technology that recently has developed to get the desired characteristics of the microorganism. That we call it genetically improvement of the microbial strain, and this technique has been used to achieve the following two broad objectives. One is the production of recombinant proteins, as I mentioned, that this is very important, and modification of the organism's metabolic pattern for the production of new, modified, and more quantity of metabolized, that is the metabolic engineering. So when we study the different biochemical pathways, we easily find out that, you know, which pathway can give us the maximum amount of product formation. So through this metabolic pathways, we can, through this recombinant DNA technology, we can develop that particular desired enzyme, so that activity of that enzyme can be increased, so that we can increase the productivity of the particular metabolized to a great extent. So this is the whole things that I want to emphasize here, that that how the industrial strain development and how preservation take place, and this is largely used by the industry for getting the desired product. Thank you very much.